Private Lives by Noel Coward, starring Helena Bonham Carter as Amanda and Bill Nighy as Elliot.
Ellie, dear, do come out. It's so lovely.
Just a minute.
Not so bad.
It's heavenly. Look at the lights off that yacht reflected in the water. Oh, dear, I'm so happy.
Are you?
Aren't you?
Of course I am. Tremendously happy.
Just to think, here we are, you and I, married.
Yeah, things have come to a pretty pass.
Don't laugh at me. You mustn't be blasé about honeymoons just because this is your second.
That's silly.
Have I annoyed you by saying that?
Just a little.
Oh, darling, I'm so sorry. Kiss me.
There.
Not so very enthusiastic.
That better?
Three times, please. I'm superstitious.
You really are very sweet.
Are you glad you married me?
Of course I am.
How glad?
Incredibly. Magnificently glad.
How lovely.
We ought to go in and dress.
Gladder than before.
Why do you keep harping on that?
It's in my mind and yours too, I expect.
It isn't anything of the sort.
She was pretty, wasn't she, Amanda?
Very pretty.
Prettier than I am?
Much.
Elliot!
She was pretty and sleek, and her hands were long and slim, and her legs were long and slim, and she danced like an angel. You danced very poorly, by the way.
Could she play the piano as well as I can?
She couldn't play the piano at all.
Aha! Had she my talent for organisation?
No, but she hadn't your mother either.
I don't believe you like mother.
I like her. I can't bear her.
Elliot! She's a darling underneath.
I never got underneath.
It makes me unhappy to think that you don't like mother.
Nonsense. I believe the only reason you married me was to get away from her.
I married you because I loved you.
Oh, dear, oh, dear, oh, dear, oh, dear.
I love you far more than Amanda loved you. I'd never make you miserable like she did.
We made each other miserable.
It was all her fault. You know it was.
Yes, it was. Entirely her fault.
She was a fool to lose you.
We lost each other.
She lost you with her violent tempers and carryings on.
Will you stop talking about Amanda?
But I'm very glad, because if she hadn't been uncontrolled and wicked and unfaithful, we shouldn't be here now.
She wasn't unfaithful.
How do you know? I bet she was. I bet she was unfaithful every 5 minutes.
It would take a far more concentrated woman than Amanda to be unfaithful every 5 minutes.
You do hate her, don't you?
No, I don't hate her. I think I despise her.
Well, that's much worse.
And yet I'm sorry for her.
Why?
Because she's marked for tragedy. She's bound to make a mess of everything.
If it's all her fault, I don't see that it matters much.
She has some very good qualities.
Considering what a hell she made of your life, I think you are very nice about her. Most men would be vindictive.
What's the use of that? It's all over now. Such a long time ago.
5 years isn't very long.
Yes, it is.
Do you think you could ever love her again?
Now then, Sybil.
But could you?
Of course not. I love you.
Yes, but you love me differently. I know that.
More wisely, perhaps.
I'm glad. I'd rather have that sort of love.
You're right. Love is no use unless it's wise and kind and undramatic. Something steady and sweet to smooth your nerves when you're tired. Something tremendously cozy and unflurried by scenes and jealousies. That's what I want, what I've always wanted, really. Oh, my dear. I do hope it's not going to be dull for you.
Sweetheart, as though you could ever be dull.
I'm much older than you.
Not so very much. The music stopped and you can hear the sea.
We'll bathe tomorrow morning.
I mustn't get sunburnt.
Why not?
I hate it on women.
Very well, you shan't then. I hope you don't hate it on men.
Of course I don't. It's suitable to men.
You're a completely feminine little creature, aren't you?
Why do you say that?
Everything in its place.
What do you mean?
If you feel you'd like me to smoke a pipe, I'll try and master it.
I like a man to be a man, if that's what you mean.
Are you going to understand me and manage me?
I'm going to try to understand you.
Run me without my knowing it.
I think you're being a little unkind.
No, I don't mean to be. I was only wondering.
Well?
I was wondering what's going on inside your mind. What your plans are, really.
Plans? Oh, Ellie.
Apart from loving me and all that, you must have plans.
I haven't the faintest idea what you're talking about.
Perhaps it's subconscious, then. Age-old instincts working away, deep down, mincing up little bits of experience for future use, watching me carefully like a little sharp-eyed blonde kitten.
How can you be so horrid?
I said kitten, not cat.
Kittens grow into cats.
Let that be a warning to you.
What's the matter, darling? Are you hungry?
Not a bit.
You're very strange all of a sudden and rather cruel. Just because I'm feminine, it doesn't mean that I'm crafty and calculating.
I didn't say you were either of those things.
I hate these half-masculine women who go banging about.
I hate anybody who goes banging about.
I should think you needed a little quiet womanliness after a man.
Why will you keep on talking about her?
It's natural enough, isn't it?
What do you want to find out?
Why did you really let her divorce you?
She divorced me for cruelty and flagrant infidelity. I spent a whole weekend at Brighton with a lady called Vera Williams. She had the nastiest looking hairbrush I've ever seen.
Misplaced chivalry, I call it. Why didn't you divorce her?
It would not have been the action of a gentleman, whatever that may mean.
I think she got off very lightly.
Once and for all, will you stop talking about her?
Yes, Ellie.
I don't wish to see her again or hear her name mentioned.
Very well, darling.
Is that understood?
Yes, darling. Where did you spend your honeymoon?
St. Moritz. Be quiet!
I hate St. Moritz!
So do I, bitterly.
Was she good on skis?
Do you want to dine downstairs here or at the casino?
I love you, I love you, I love you.
Good. Let's go in and dress.
Kiss me first.
Casino?
Yes. Are you a gambler? You never told me.
Every now and then.
I shall come and sit just behind your chair and bring you luck.
That will be fatal. Mandy!
What?
Come outside. The view is wonderful.
I'm still damp from the bath. Wait a minute. Ooh.
I shall catch pneumonia. That's what I shall catch.
God!
I beg your pardon?
You look wonderful.
Thank you, darling.
Like a beautiful advertisement for something.
Nothing peculiar, I hope.
I can hardly believe it's true. You and I here alone, together, married.
That jacket's very rough.
Don't you like it?
A bit hearty, isn't it?
Do you love me?
Of course. That's why I'm here.
More than you loved.
Now then, none of that.
No, but do you love me more than you loved Elliot?
I don't remember. It's such a long time ago.
Well, not so very long.
All my life ago.
I'd like to break his damn neck.
Why?
For making you unhappy.
It was mutual.
Rubbish. It was all his fault. You know it was.
Yes, it was. Now I come to think about it.
Swine.
Don't be so vehement, darling.
I'll never treat you like that.
That's right.
I love you too much.
So did he.
A fine sort of love, that is. He struck you once, didn't he?
More than once.
Where?
Several places.
What a cad.
I struck him too. Once I broke 4 gramophone records over his head. It was very satisfying.
You must have been driven to distraction.
Yes, I was. But don't let's talk about it, please. After all, it's a dreary subject for our honeymoon night.
He didn't know when he was well off.
Look at the lights of that yacht reflected in the water. Wonder whose it is.
We must bathe tomorrow.
Yes, I want to get a nice sunburn.
Mandy.
What's the matter?
I hate sunburnt women.
Why?
It's somehow, well, unsuitable.
It's awfully suitable to me, darling.
Of course, if you really wanted to.
I'm absolutely determined. I've got masses of lovely oil to rub all over myself.
Your skin is so beautiful as it is.
Wait and see. When I'm done a nice crisp brown, you'll fall in love with me all over again.
I couldn't love you more than I do now.
Oh, dear. I did so hope our honeymoon was going to be progressive.
Where did you spend your last one?
Victor.
I want to know.
St. Moritz. Very attractive.
I hate St. Moritz.
So do I.
Did he start quarrelling with you right away?
Within the first few days. I put it down to high altitudes.
And you loved him?
Yes, Victor.
You poor child.
Let's try not to be pompous, dear.
Mandy.
I don't believe I'm a bit like what you think I am.
How do you mean?
I was never a poor child.
A figure of speech, dear, that's all.
I suffered a good deal and had my heart broken, but it wasn't an innocent, girlish heart. It was jagged with sophistication. I've always been sophisticated. Far too knowing. That caused many of my rows with Elliot. I irritated him because he knew I could see through him.
I don't mind how much you can see through me.
Oh, sweet.
I'm going to make you happy.
Are you?
Yeah, just by looking after you and seeing that you're all right, you know?
No, don't know.
I think you love me quite differently from the way you loved Elliot.
Oh, do stop harping on Elliot.
Well, it's true, though, isn't it?
I love you much more calmly, if that's what you mean.
More lastingly?
I expect so.
Do you remember when I first met you?
Yes.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.